In our previous lesson, we learned about some of interior anger, and now we are on interior anger. Interior angers are angers found inside a plane figure. They are angers found inside a plane figure. This is a triangle. And angles found inside this plane figure are called interior angles. So A, B, and C, they are interior angles. And the formula for interior angle, is the sum of interior angle, sum of interior angle over F is the sum of interior angle over F. And we know our sum of interior angle as 180 N minus 2 over F. That's why I first taught you how to find sum of interior angle. Because once you know your sum of interior angle, to find your interior angle, you just divide the formula by the number of sides. Let's take our first example. Example one. Find the interior angle of a three-sided figure. Find the interior angle of a three-sided figure. This means our n is equal to what? 3. So the interior angle is equal to 180 n minus 2 over n. And the simplest formula is to find your sum of interior angle first. So it becomes 180 bracket n minus 1, 2. And we know our number of sides as 3. So 180, 3 minus 2. 180, 2 from 3, we are getting what? 1. So it's 180 degrees. We now know our sum of interior angle to be what? 180 degrees. So if you are asked to find your interior angle, it's your sum of interior angle over the number of what? Sides. And the sum of interior angle now is what? 180 degrees over the n, which is 3. So it becomes 60 degrees, because 3 goes into 18, 6, and you add your 0 to 8, 60 degrees. Or one can decide to eliminate this n and put this 3 inside. So wherever you see n, you can fix your 3. So this means it becomes 180 bracket 3 minus 2 over 3. But that one is a complicated method. So you just find your sum of interior angle. After that, to get each interior angle, you divide this 180 over the number of sides. Let's take our last example on interior angle when given the number of sides. Given n as 4. Find the interior angle. And this is our formula. So it becomes, you first find the sum of interior angle, and the formula is 180 n minus 2. So 180, our n is 4. 2. So 2 from 4, you are getting 2. So this becomes 360, because 180 times 2 is what? 360 degrees. And our interior angle now becomes the sum of interior angle over the end. Now, what is our sum of interior angle? It is 360 degrees over end, which is what? 4. So 4 goes here, 1, 4 goes here, and it becomes 90 degrees. And I believe this is simple. So always, if you are asked to calculate the interior angle of a polygon, you first find the sum of interior angle. And after getting your sum of interior angle, you divide it by the number of sides. You see, when I took the number of sides as 3, we have each interior angle to be 60 degrees. This means if you take a triangle, each interior angle of a triangle is equal to 60 degrees. 60 degrees. So this means once you sum them up, it becomes sum of interior angle. So each interior angle of a triangle is what? 60 degrees. Let's take that one I set the number of sides to be 4. And that one too, we have 90 degrees. This means each interior angle of a quadrilateral is what? 90 degrees. And once you sum them up, it becomes 360 degrees. That becomes the sum of interior angle. So, at times too, they will give you the interior angle, and they will ask you to find the number of sides. I will take an example here, just one example. When giving the interior angle, they will ask you to find the number of sides. So I just created the video. I wanted it to be encouraging, because you see, the first session I taught you how to find the interior angle, and now they will give you interior angle and they will say find the number of sides. So giving interior angle as 60 degrees, find the number of sides. And for this one, we use the formula approach. There is no need for you to find the sum of interior angles. After that, you divide it by the number of sides, because they have asked you to find the number of sides. So it becomes interior angle, which is 180 n minus 2 over n. Elimination by substitution. We eliminate this and we fix this one here. We fix it. So it becomes 60 is equal to 180 n minus 2 over n. And every whole number is over 1. Over 1. So you multiply this 60 by n. Let me use another color so that you easily understand it. You multiply this one by this, and this one two by this. And you know that 1 times any number is equal to the same number. So it becomes 180 n minus 2 equal to 60 times n is 60 m. So we remove brackets. Once we are having brackets, 180 m 180 times 2, you are getting 360 equal to 60 m. And in maths, whenever there is an equal sign, you group like terms. You group like terms. You see, we are having energy, but this one is not having any variable being attached. So you separate it. You separate the sheep from the dogs. So it becomes, I will bring this to stage. And once it is positive and is crossing the equal sign, it becomes negative, equal to 360. So 60N from 180N, it becomes 120N, equal to 360 degrees. And you know the coefficient of N is 120, because always coefficient of a variable is equal to the number. You divide both sides by the coefficient of N, which is 120. Because in maths, what you do to the left-hand side of the equation, you must do the same thing to the right-hand side of the equation. This one will cancel this, is now left with our variable. This will cancel this. And 12 goes into 36, so our N becomes 3. Thank you, and this brings us to the end of this session. There is a general question, or there are general questions on polygon, and that will be our next session. General questions on polygon. Even though we now have an insight on polygons, that's for exterior angle, some of interior angle and interior angle, but there are general questions on polygon. Please, if you are interested, you subscribe, share, and turn your notification on so that whenever I upload my video, you have a look at it. Thank you and have a nice day.